The White Helmets abandoned their centres, their headquarters in East Aleppo, alongside Nusra Front in the final evacuations under the Syrian government amnesty agreement. So we were able to go to Sahur in Hanano, to the main White Helmet centre. And our discovery there was that basically the M10 hospital, the Nusra Front headquarters, and the White Helmet headquarters in this area were right next door to each other. In fact, the Nusra Front, the wall that divided Nusra Front from the White Helmets, had entrances into the White Helmet Center. So the entire compound was united, let's say. And then entering that White Helmet compound, we found on the outside a clear affiliation to the original moderate extremists, the Free Syrian Army. And then upon entering the building, we found plenty of evidence that linked them to Nusra Front flags, Nusra Front
Logos,
graffiti on the walls, etc. Equally, we then went on to Bab al-Nereb and to Maje, which were other areas that had White Helmet centers. In Bab al-Nereb, we found not only the buildings, the White Helmet center was actually shared with Nusra Front. They were working alongside each other, but we also met with civilians from the area that told us unequivocally that the White Helmets and Nusra Front worked together.
Together, yeah.
And actually, in this center, there was one room that we were told was used as an execution and a torture chamber, and that the White Helmets and Nusra Front were bringing prisoners
And
there,
torturing them.
yeah, which were effectively civilians that were not capitulating to the terrorist factions in East Aleppo, who were maintaining their support for the Syrian state and for the Syrian army, or were simply disagreeing with them ideologically. They were being rounded up by both the White Helmets and by Nusra Front and by other extremist factions like Noradan Zinki, like Tawhid Brigade, like Ara al-Sham. And the White Helmets also, excuse me, we found paperwork that linked them very clearly to the various extremist factions.
Terrorist groups,
Yeah,
yeah.
demonstrating that they worked alongside Nusra Front, protecting certain areas, that Nusra Front were putting out statements declaring that electricity should be supplied to the White Helmets. So there was very clear correlation in their working patterns, but also very clear evidence, again, to corroborate the testimonies from civilians from East Aleppo in December, to clearly show that the White Helmets were working as Nusra Front civil defense first and foremost. The White Helmets were established externally to Syria in Turkey. And if we actually look at the geography of Syria right now during the conflict, 80% of Syrians inside Syria, including the over 6 million internally displaced, are under the protection, under the control, but rather the protection of the Syrian state and the Syrian army. And it is those 80% of the Syrian population that are being serviced by the real Syria civil defense. The White Helmets are effectively only working in 20% of the inhabited areas, but those inhabited areas, the civilians in those areas, are under the control, the occupation, and the extremist rule of the terrorist factions, the many militant and extremist groups that are being funded by exactly the same governments who are funding the White Helmets. And we know from the experience in East Aleppo that those civilians will be living under extremist rule, under imprisonment, under possible deprivation, universal violations of their human
Wahhabi
rights.
thinking.
Yeah,
Yeah.
Wahhabi extreme ideology. And we know from the experience in the East Aleppo that the White Helmets will only be working for and on behalf of the terrorist factions, not actually for the civilians. We know, for example, the leader of the White Helmets in Khan Shohun, Mustafa Alhaj Yusuf, we know that he has clear affiliations to the extremist groups. That's one. We know that the White Helmets, if we look back across the 3 years since their inception, we have seen them always conveniently producing a false flag that is later discredited. For example, after the United States coalition bombed the Syrian Arab Army soldiers in Deir ez-Zor, almost within 48 hours, we saw the White Helmets produce a so-called Syrian or Russian Air Force attack on the humanitarian convoy in Umm al-Qabra in Aleppo. And this is a pattern that we see. When the US coalition has committed, frankly, war crimes inside Syria, the White Helmets have produced a false flag. Or when there is a need for a no-fly zone or to call for further intervention, the White Helmets are there to produce the false flag which facilitates that no-fly zone. And this is a pattern that we've seen, and we can understand that that is their role. That is one of the reasons for which they were produced and created.